The government has just launched a new program for the youth.
Sometimes I really wonder where all the money the government and their development partners put into the youth sector go. Because you read reports of how much the government and their development partners had poured in the youth sector, and how much development partners also poured in addressing the problem affecting the youth, in terms of youth empowerment, youth unemployment, youth violence. But at the end of the day, we are only seeing things getting worse.
That is business as usual, my sister. Old wine in new bottle.
But things shouldn't continue like this.
You are talking like you are not from Sierra Leone. These people are making fortunes out of our predicament. If the government really cares about we the youth, then solving our problem would be an issue. But because they want to continue receiving donor funding and sharing the country's wealth, they'll continue giving us excuses and making fun of we the youth.
How do you think this problem can be addressed?
According to government statistics, they said 6% of our youth are unemployable, right?
Yeah,
from that statement, you can clearly see that for us to make the youth employable, we have to what? Empower them. Secondly, imagine they revisit our college curriculum, amend it, teach our brothers what they need to know. When they graduate, they'll be employable or even create opportunities for themselves. That will prevent thousands from being employed every year. But they will not do it because they need to not funding. Rather, they will train our, they will teach our brothers full stop, train our doctors and engineers on scrap, teach our IT brothers theory. And at the end of it, they want them to create or invent programs.
Yeah, I see your point. Many issues have rise up concerning the revision of our models. Up to now, no result. The world is fast moving, but our system is still in the 19th series. No wonder we are still behind in terms of development and technology. And when they fail in their obligations, they blame we the youth of being idle and lazy.
Sometimes it really pains me when I see our youth perishing with their potentials just because our leaders do not have the best interests at heart. They blame us for not being creative. But have they provided us the enabling environment for us to thrive? Most of countries are booming today because even children have the enabling environment. But here, they fire us with our own oil.
That is the long version of development. The youth are not giving the president millions of yuans, but the investors are.
This is their main problem. They think that by bringing investors, our country will be developed after failing to empower we the youth. When these investors come, they focus so much on making profit and sending the profit back to their country, whilst exploiting we the youth and employing us under poor condition of services.
That's very true, my brother. It's here you will see one government coming into power saying that it will die for the youth. But at the end of the day, it's the youth that will end up dying. And soon we end up in drugs abuse, tramadol, and even robbery in order to make ends meet. I'm not the one who comes saying that we will provide an enabling environment in order for the youth to strive and make meaningful contribution to the national development. But you take your program to their office, my brother, you will get frustrated. I've sought all the bookshop in town trying to look for a dictionary that probably defines enabling environment. But to me, it's disabled environment.
They say success leaves clues. Now, let us take a look at the first world countries. How many of their top companies are being owned by foreigners? All their companies are being owned by their own citizens. Their money stays in their own country. They sponsor their best students to go to study abroad and master their craft. And when they come, they employ them. But here, politics over everything. We have our own game, sister.
We are taking this as fun, but it's not really funny. If only the president would boost up the youth sector, not only by speech, but by action, our country will boom. We will regain our lost glory. We will become once more the anthem of West Africa. With all the resources in our disposal, we need not to go after investors, they need to come after us. Our president do not need to go out there and sell talent. When the youth can do that for them, if only we are empowered. But oh yeah, if you go ask for home, you see the parents washing dishes while the children are around. Everyone need not to ask.
You're very right, my sister. Government need to establish many centers and make it very affordable and effective, and also introduce seminars where they can train our youth to enter into entrepreneurship. I really wish the president would get this message.
I pray so.